Hi, this is Darren Coons with ASHP TV, and I'm here with Staff Sergeant Mary Johnson, and you are the 2017 PTCB Certified Pharmacy Technician of the Year Award winner. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Darren.
Absolutely. So tell us a little bit about the work that you've been doing.
So I've been in the United States Air Force for the past 8.5 years.
Okay.
And upon coming into the Air Force, I became a pharmacy technician.
Okay.
I've been a certified pharmacy technician for the past 3 years now.
Okay. And so how did you get certified? What was that process like?
Certified upon completing our basic training program for our career field. We go through a 16-week program. Mm-hmm. Upon completion of that, I set up the registration and took the PTCB exam.
Okay. And then how did you get started with your work to win this award?
So I was actually nominated by a colleague.
Okay.
This colleague surprised me completely.
Right.
Told me that I was nominated, and then basically it just took off from there.
And what was the work you were doing that you got nominated for?
So I currently work at Geilenkirchen.
Okay.
Geilenkirchen is a NATO air base in Germany.
Right.
I am one of three Air Force technicians that work at a pharmacy without a pharmacist on site.
Okay.
So our roles and responsibilities are a little bit on the technician side as
right.
well as on the pharmacist side.
Okay. And with your work, what results have you seen?
We have seen a 50% cutback with a double range dosing.
Okay.
So double range dosing is 1 to 2 tablets every 4 to 6 hours
okay.
or 6 to 8 hours.
Right.
Our providers at our team have basically taken that and cut it down to 1 tablet.
Wow.
Every 8 hours or six
okay.
hours, according to the pain management.
Fantastic. And is this the sort of work then you would hope would be brought up by other organizations that can move to other places and you can kind of inform them of your results and let them integrate this into their practice?
Oh, yes, sir.
Absolutely.
In order to combat the opioid epidemic that's
right.
currently impacting the states,
right.
in Germany, we decided to take a proactive approach
okay.
with the military healthcare system.
Right. So this is something that you can show the results and have other people start to take this
yes,
on.
Yes, sir.
Is that something you're working on now?
We're trying to move that way.
Okay.
Our Spangdahlem, the 52nd Fighter Wing
right.
in Germany.
Yep.
They've already adopted it into
Fantastic.
Their med group instruction guide.
Great.
So
it is being integrated.
We're looking to see it at a bigger level.
And how can federal technicians learn from community technicians and vice versa?
Taking the time to get to know your community
mm-hmm.
is the biggest step.
Okay.
The DoD is oftentimes a lot slower
right.
with integrating innovation, technology.
Right.
So to have the partnership to take a military technician and expose them to a civilian technician
right.
and what they go through on a
right.
day-to-day basis
right.
is the best way to enhance.
So there's sort of just a learning between the two and an understanding.
It's a shared information.
Right, right.
Take pride in what you do, and we're all technicians.
Right. Well, that's fantastic. And again, congratulations on your award.
Thank you so much,
Darren. And thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us at ASHP TV.